lack of sexual intimacy and body maintenance. And you know, some of you are holding clothes. You came from churches where they don't preach all things, and then there are problems. I prefer to have a peaceful church than counseling people every day. I better tell you the truth in the Bible. Hello, I'm a pastor, so I counsel people every day. I know the problem, so I better address the things. One area we have peace in this church is marriages. I hope you know that. Lack of sexual what? Sexual intimacy. No marriage can be peaceful when the husband and the wife are not sexually intimate. It is common for a spouse to be uninterested or unwilling to have sex because the person is emotionally dissatisfied, tired, or sick. This fallout of events has led to the breakup of many marriages. Once you stop having regular sexual intercourse with your spouse, you create a gap that may be detrimental to the smooth running of the home. We must not defraud each other under any guise, particularly when one party corrects the other party for an error observed. It is your lawful and spiritual duty to give yourself to your spouse daily or as often as it is required. It is a criminal offense before God. Fraud. Fraud. What did I say? Fraud is an offense. Fraud is what? When you deny your spouse the right to have marital affairs with you for flimsy reasons. Let's see it from the Bible, so you don't think I'm talking my own. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, 3 to 5. 3 to what? Okay, look at the Bible. I'm not the one who wrote the Bible. It's always good I wrote the Bible. And you are not holier than God. 1 Corinthians 7. Let your husband render unto the wife due benevolence, and likewise also the wife unto the what? Look at it. The wife had no power of her own body. Is it your Bible? But the husband. And likewise, the husband had no power of his own body. But what? The wife. Shall we read 5 together? If it's in your Bible, want to go? Defraud. Defraud means if you do it, it's fraud. Criminal offense. Defraud me not, except it be with consent for a time, that you may give yourself to fast. The only reason is two of you agree that we must fast and pray. That is the only reason. Otherwise, when your husband says, I want, don't say I'm tired. I'm preaching what some of all our men of God, so that's the victims of it. You fast, you forget your wife. Hey! Let me tell you, this area is what has caused problems in marriages. And women don't know how to express their emotions because they are very reserved. So they don't bottle over, they get it and they get angry. When you see a woman and a husband quarreling, and you say, what is wrong? The woman say, it's a wicked man. It's a wicked man, wicked man. I say, what is wrong? And I say, just a wicked man. No, this is the problem. This is women can't talk like men. Men can talk. Say, this is my wife, but women can't talk. They should be looking at the face of people. Say, how can I talk? Let her know I'm a bad woman. But she's dying. Hey, women. And so that time they just get angry. He said, what is the problem? The man said, I bought a car, I give this man everything. He said, now look at you as a pastor. Sir, it's a wicked man, wicked man. He said, why? He said, what? I built the house for her, I give everything she wants. He said, you can't take your house, take everything. The bottom line. Are you hearing what I'm saying? This is where the problem is. Come on, here. Hey, God said, don't defraud one another. But sometimes I'm being led by the Spirit of God. I know when I hear God in my little way. Sometimes some men can't perform because of their health. I know when I hear. Maybe a man is sick, diabetic. A man is sick, his body can't move. The wife can't do anything. She
is under punishment. The man is not satisfied. But to such men, under this power of the Holy Spirit, I pronounce you healed in Jesus' name. Every man with such problem in your body, that as a man you can't perform your duty as a man because of your health, be healed in the name of Jesus. If somebody right to this service, receive that healing in Jesus' name. It is frustrating when a man can't do what he's supposed to do. And somebody's healed. I know it when I know. I know it is, I know my name. The man is healed right now. The next time you will testify in Jesus' name. Now hear this. The husband and the wife must also make sex appealing and pleasurable. I know some of you are looking at me and saying, dear Papa, introduce variety. Not just one pattern that makes the whole exercise boring. This is church. Hear this truth. It is better for the woman to be satisfied than the man if he wants peace. Pastors don't preach this, and there's too much problem in the church. Watch the facial expression of your wife and find out whether she's enjoying what you're doing. Otherwise, you are destroying the whole relationship. Don't engage in the exercise with the sole aim of satisfying yourself alone. That is selfishness. Any sexual exercise where one party is inactive, dormant, and the other party is very active is simply a glorified rape. Don't defraud your spouse on the pretense that you are married someone you did not love. They didn't hypnotize you before you got into the marriage. If you voluntarily entered into it, you must voluntarily tolerate it until your time on earth is over. Don't say, I will not because I don't love him. You have entered. Stay there. In case you don't love him, go and find out the true meaning of love. Yeah, this sex is not for procreation alone. God did not create it for procreation. He created it for the pleasure of husband and wife. And this is, if you want peace during the exercise, don't abuse the body of your wife. Don't even abuse the body of your husband. Don't say, look at the size of your woman. Don't say so. Don't say how your tummy is floppy. She's stretch mark all over you. You don't say such things during the exercise. They are not said during the... You say that before, after, but not doing it to dampen the spirit of the person. You know, some of you are saying, is Papa talking like that? And so I know what I'm talking. And these are things they don't talk. Nobody wants to say that as if they are committing sin. God will put it in the marriage. Is he a sinner? B. Body maintenance. Body maintenance. Are you still there? In Songs of Solomon chapter 5 and verse 10. My blood is white and ruddy, the chiefest among 10,000. Songs of Solomon chapter 4, 12 to 16. He said, a garden enclosed is my sister and my spouse. A spring shut up, a fountain sealed. Thy plants are an orchard of pomegranates. With blizzard fruits, kaffir, with sparknet and saffron, calamus and cinnamon, with orchards of frankincense, myrrh and aloes, with all the chief spices. A fountain, look at verse 15, a fountain of gardens, a well of living waters, a source from Lebanon. Awake, O north wind, and come, thou south, blow upon my garden, that the spices thereof may flow out. Let my beloved come into his garden and eat his bizarre food. The psalmist is speaking. Solomon here was reading poems. He said, put yourself attractive for your spouse to come close. Hello. Make yourself attractive. Come on, sir, here. under B, Romans figure 1, avoid overweight. Cut down on your food intake and engage in regular exercise. Am I talking to you? Avoid what? Overweight. Both parties avoid overweight. Are you getting what I'm saying? Avoid overweight. Romans figure 2. Avoid general body odor. Mouth, armpit, and general body. Use mouthwash and brush your mouth regularly. Clean your tongue. Hear this. Let me tell the men, especially in this area. Most times it's men. Hey, listen. Listen. Don't deceive yourself. Hey, listen. Your wife can never tell your mouth is smelling. No wife can do that. You should know that your mouth is offensive. If you don't clean tongue, no, no. Most men, when they talk to you, they can't. You know. On your own. It's not like you need to do it properly. On your own, you know. Don't you know? In the morning when you have not brushed, don't you know the other? So, listen. Listen. The what makes the man smell is not the teeth, it's the tongue. There are men who never clean their tongue. Every day your tongue should be clean. Hello? If you say you have my tongue, go to a dentist. Once in a while, clean your teeth. Don't use touch to cover up. Go to a dentist, do mouth wash. When you clean everywhere, your mouth will be very fresh. You are using chalk to cover up. Your wife can't tell you. Can your wife tell you your mouth is smelly? Which wife can tell that? I'm telling you now. Brush your mouth. We have roller. We have perfume. We have what? Smell fine. Bathe regularly. How can a woman walk in the whole day? You don't bathe in the evening. What kind of woman are you? Even if you don't bathe, wash yourself. Your husband can't tell you that women who don't clean themselves, a woman, Abba. Listen, this is the men who come near there. Did you hear what I said? Shave your armpit. Shave your what? No woman should put hair in her armpit. If you have hair now, as I'm talking, you're not clean. Do you hear me at all? Yeah. What are your truth? Yeah. Okay. That you are giving birth does not mean you need exercise. Work on your flappy tummy. Pot belly is no longer in vogue. All the men will have problems, go and do exercise. We reduce it at once. They call it balance but forward. Number 8. Managing family finance. That's where out of 10 divorce, 9 has to do with this one. Ewo. Lack of financial wisdom is the major source of family conflict. Many families have been stressed, frustrated, pressured, and even traumatized because of financial problems. School fees, house rent, day-to-day family bills. You hear me? Money problem cannot be solved through prayer and fasting. It can only be solved with the wisdom of God. You don't use prayer and fasting to solve money problem. I'm an authority in this area. You can only solve money problem through wisdom. Through what? Wisdom. Prayer and fasting does not solve money problem. It can solve other problems but not money problem. It's only wisdom that solves money problem. God said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. So, Luke 4 verse 18. The gospel must be preached, not prayer, not casting. Said, to, you have sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to set the captives free, to preach deliverance, and the rest of them. Hear this. We need financial knowledge to grow a steady and stable family. First Corinthians chapter 6 verse 12. Are you still happy with me?
Yes. Even if you're not happy, what will you do now?
You just have to be happy. Tell them about be happy.
Yeah.
Papa is telling you the truth.
Yeah.
Be happy.
Yeah.
Plan.
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 So of course, prayer is no substitute for planning. Sit down. Let husband and wife sit down. Our income is 120. So what do? We tithe 12,000. Offering this. Trust school fees, this. Give some in the bank. So remaining 40,000 out of the 120. House rent 20,000 for the month. So every month we save 3,000. So 20 times 12 is what is it? The figure? 240. So the house as you leave, you should be what? 240. I don't need prayer for that. Do I need prayer for that? But now I'm going to live in a house of 600,000. That's stupidity. That's stupidity. It's absolute. Where am I going to get the rest from? 1 Corinthians 6, 12. All things are lawful to me. But all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me. But I will not be brought under the power of any. You hear that? Hello? I will not allow things to weigh me down. I go for what I can afford, so I hear. Life is in phases, men are in sizes. A time will come, it means nothing. So of course we are living that life as you want to die quick. Why overstress your life? Don't try to compare yourself with anybody. Hello, my friend is living, carrying his children overseas, so we must go for summer. So of course the summer we have gone is enough to build a house. You are living in a rented house using four cars. Your head is not correct. Your cars are even more expensive than your landlord. That's why every year is increasing the bill. He said, this is my tenant, the using Mercedes Benz. He has money, so he increases his next money. He said, now 2 million, 8 million. He said, this is my increasing. The car you park in his house is enough for him to increase your house rent. Do you hear anything? Leave your size, families. Leave your what?
Size.
Avoid impulse buying. Obey the impulse buying. You have money. Anything you see, just buy. Say, bring it. Bring it. Amos, bring impulse buying. Amos. You see something? Say, bring it. It was not part of your plan. Plan your budget. Plan your. Look. Financial plan is very important for every marriage that must make progress. Listen, there's one factor that is the summary of all. When you hear husband and wife, you talk, there's no progress, there's nothing working. That's a major factor. You hear a young girl, she wants to marry. You hear a young man, he wants to marry. You say, go and marry. They give all manner of excuses. They are not progress. You see a husband and wife, their marriage is not working. You say, look, I want to go to divorce. They say, there's one factor. The moment that factor is not in place, nothing works. It is called change. Once a person is willing to change, things are bound to work. But if a wife or a husband, you talk and talk, they defend, talk, they are not willing to change. And when you don't change, you can't make progress in marriage. There's no advice, there's no teaching that can make a family go forward, except the female is ready to change. Change is the only way to make progress. And if you don't change, you remain in chains. Change is the proof that you are growing. If you are not changing, you are not growing. When you hear a man, you tell him, well, don't divorce. He says, I'm going to divorce. He's not ready to change. You hear a woman, love, leave this matter. Let's go forward. She says, no. She's not ready to change.